George, there's someone in the house. I heard something.
Escape from Greenwood.
Dangerous?
Yeah, the roadblocks all over the place.
Excuse me. I want to get to Greenwood Station.
Well, there's only one bus on a Sunday. I'd left 10 minutes ago.
Yes, I know. Can I get a cab?
Not round here, I'm afraid. Hang on a minute. Jim, you're heading for Greenwood.
Yep, but no passengers.
Sir, your bottle.
Oh, come on. Can't let her walk. A maniac on the loose. What time's the train?
There's one at 2 o'clock.
You make it easy. Quick, get down.
What?
It's another roadblock. I'm not allowed to give lifts.
Where have you come from?
Birmingham. My job.
I can't thank you enough.
Want a bit? You a model, huh?
No.
Could be. You'll be glad I came along.
I'm very grateful to you.
I hope you say that.
Killed, you know? You can drown or die of pneumonia. Come on, get in.
Yeah. This will warm you up.
No, thanks.
Weren't you at the roadhouse?
Yes. Got a lift. The fare was too high.
Oh, one of those.
One of those.
Oh, you're asking for it, hitching lists with those drivers.
No choice. My car broke down. It's going to take a couple of days to fix. Anyway, I can take care of myself.
Glad to hear it. Haven't you got a case or anything?
I wasn't planning on spending the night. I have to get a few things in Wickham tomorrow.
You know how long it takes to boil an ostrich egg? 4 hours.
Really?
4 hours. Imagine having to wait that long for breakfast. Well, I've got this book, How to Win Friends. It says, well, to break the ice, you have to say something. So I said, you see, it works.
Escaped late last night from the Greenwood Mental Hospital. Residents have been warned to lock all doors and windows.
You got a cigarette?
And to report immediately.
No, sorry. They're always breaking out of there.
Hmm?
Greenwood. Oh, sorry, I thought I was out. Yeah, it's where they send you if you're guilty but insane.
Hmm. Heard of the place.
It's funny, I've been reading a lot about those cases recently. Bright as rain one minute and the next.
Got a match?
Some of them look so normal, to look at them, you never think they were dangerous. In fact, half of them don't even know it themselves. Sorry, I've got a lighter somewhere.
Also have matches. You should have turned left.
What?
You should have gone left. There was a sign. You've taken the wrong road.
Well, I can't turn here.
You can back up.
You know, I read somewhere that only one woman in 10 can wink.
Certainly are a mine of information, Mr.
Slade. Stephen Slade. And you? What's your name?
Belle. Belle Adams.
Ah, Belle. The beautiful one. Well, that's what it means, your name. Belle means the beautiful one.
Don't tell me. You read it somewhere.
How did you know? Did you say you're going to Wickham?
Yes. I can pick up a connection in Southcliff. Thanks.
No, wait. I'll go and check on your train. You never know. You might have to wait a few minutes. We can have a cup of coffee.
Okay.
The last train's just left.
But there's one at 2 o'clock.
There isn't another one till tomorrow. Well, it's Sunday. They only run a skeleton service. You can go and check for yourself if you like. It's all my fault. If we hadn't taken that wrong turning, we might have made it.
Better find some place to stay.
No, you won't find anywhere around here.
Look, I've got some business to do at Southcliff. Well, there's a small hotel that I sometimes stay near there. They're bound to have some rooms. Well, what do you say?
I don't seem to have much choice.
I know Wickham.
Do you?
I've been there quite a few times. Beautiful beach.
Yes.
Come on, Belle. It's time to go now. Come on. We're going home.
Driving, I'm fine, but the moment I get in the passenger seat...
Do you want me to stop for a minute?
No, no, it's past. I'm okay.
You were talking about Wickham.
I lived there. Till my parents were killed in an accident. After that, I went to live with my uncle.
Thank God. I thought it was another roadblock. Dodged two already today.
Why?
No, you were right. I've had one too many. Can't afford to be stopped.
Why do you drink so much?
Well, I've been on the wagon for ages, but... Well, it's my birthday today. You know how it is.
Is it really your birthday?
Yes. But don't ask me how many.
I won't. Many happy... I thought you said the last train had gone.
Well, I asked the porter.
What's the next stop?
Springfield, I think.
How far is it?
Well, about 6 miles.
Well, if you could catch it, I could pick it up there.
I can't catch it in these.
Well, you could try.
I hope they didn't get my number.
You lied to me, didn't you, about that train? Why? I suppose that hotel of yours has some cozy double rooms.
No, it wasn't like that. I liked your company. I had a long way to drive and I didn't want to lose you. You were talking about your uncle.
Was I?
Yeah. You said that after your parents died, you went to live with him at Wickham.
Well, have a good ride.
Bye. I know this will sound crazy, but I suddenly had this yearning to visit Wickham, just to see where I used to live. How's the time?
No, it must be about 2:30.
Don't you have a watch?
It's at the mender's. I must remember to pick it up.
Where do you live?
Birmingham. Got a room there. No, not that I'm hardly ever there. Stay in hotels, mostly.
Are you a traveller?
Yes.
Can't be much of a life.
Got no complaints. I mean, everyone you meet's got some problem, haven't they?
Oh? What's yours?
Come on, it'll be all right in here. Better lock the door, just in case.
Some petrol. I said you need some petrol. You're almost out.
Can't seem to find anyone. Oh, are you open?
Oh, I'm always open, love. What do you want? Petrol?
Yes, 5, please.
You haven't got your buttons done up, have you?
Oh, I forgot.
Have you got a telephone around here?
Yeah, there's one round the corner, love.
Oh, thanks.
Sure.
Shan't be long.
Thank you.
Sorry to be so long.
Bit. Had to phone my boss and tell him I'll be in Southcliff tomorrow.
What do you sell?
Have a guess.
Vacuum cleaners? No. No, encyclopedias. Possible. No, I'd say farm equipment. I peeked. Who's Hargreaves?
Hargreaves? Oh. He's the chap who had this job before I took it on.
Sworn for us.
Couple of cokes.
Me.
No, really. It's all right, thanks. Forgot the matches.
Hell, I will.
Lie down.
God's sake, stop! Will you stop? Bloody fool!
Well, I didn't start it.
Well, stop! He might be dead!
Stop! You saw what happened?
Yes, I saw, all right. You went completely crazy. Now stop!
What the hell are you doing?
Will you stop? I want to get out!
For God's sake, don't be so stupid!
Talking to the lady. You all right?
Yes. Yes, fine.
Well, you're sure everything's okay?
Yes, everything's perfectly okay. Thanks.
Why didn't you say something? You had the chance. All right, you win. Come on. Let's go back and take a look.
It's a bit late for that now, isn't it?
Why? What do you mean?
Those two will be there ahead of us, and the police could be there by now. One whiff of your breath. I think I'd better drive. I can drive, you know. Or do you want to see my license?
I don't know. An hour, maybe.
Move a little closer. Excuse me, sir. Can you just tell me where you've come from?
Killed back there. They could have your number.
Ready?
How long does it take to put out a call? Come on, let's get off the road. They can't stay there forever.
Well, just past the place back there. Listen, Belle, I think the best thing is for me to take you to the nearest village and you to find a room in a hotel. If that boy's dead, I don't want you involved.
If he's dead, you'll need a witness.
I don't understand you. One minute you want to get out, and the next you're trying to help me.
You helped me, didn't you?
Might have been better if I hadn't.
Sorry you gave me a lift.
No. Of course not. Here, let me.
Then.
It's difficult to talk about.
say something?
No. Good night.
I should make love to you.
Hey, there. No.
Isn't that nice? Huh? Come on. Lie down. Yeah, right there. Very nice indeed.
Careful, your husband's next thing.
Come on, come with me.
Bonjour, mademoiselle. May I be allowed both the pleasure and the privilege of offering you a ride in this magnificent motor vehicle of mine?
Oh, I hasten to assure you that my offer is made with the very best of intentions. In fact, I would even go so far as to say that you should feel highly honored, perhaps even flattered. For you've been fortunate enough to encounter someone who is both, Momo. As I was saying, someone who is witty, chivalrous, impeccably mannered, and exceedingly handsome to boot.
And by no means immodest.
And by no means immodest. In fact, if I have a fault, which is doubtful, it is that I sometimes become overly enthusiastic.
Thank you.
Voila. You will, of course, have dinner with me this evening.
Don't believe in wasting any time, do you?
No. We Fortescue Robarts never do. It's the family motto. Facto summa celeritate, which means, roughly translated, proceed with all possible haste.
Your accent is showing.
You mean the result of my 42-year stay in the United States. And it's still noticeable, eh?
Oh, only every now and again.
Well, what I shall then do is dispense with the Fortescue and simply announce myself as Malcolm Robarts.
Belle Adams.
Belle Adams. Enchanté. Belle Adams. What a beautiful name. Malcolm and Belle Robarts. Goes rather well together, eh? Sort of rolls off the tongue.
We haven't even had dinner yet.
No, you're quite correct. That being the case, what I shall then do is exercise incredible self-control and not mention the matter again until I propose over brandy and coffee or whatever is the liquor of your delectation. Of course, after dinner, we could always,
go back to your place.
Mind you, there's one problem. I could not promise you breakfast.
Oh, I couldn't presume on your hospitality that far.
But on the other hand, if you actually pressured me, I guess I could always rustle up some bacon and eggs.
It wouldn't be practical. You see, I'm an early riser, and I know how you older people need your sleep.
I tell you, there's a lot of mileage left in this old dog yet. Rather like my friend here. May look a bit rusty, but it can still do the ton.
Without falling to pieces?
That, my dear, we jointly accept as a challenge. My dear, I was quite serious about my offer of dinner this evening.
We've only just had lunch.
Hardly what we could call lunch, you know. We're out of season, you know, at the moment. What I had in mind was that perhaps this evening we could drive out into the country and...
The lunch was excellent. Thank you.
Alternatively, of course, we could always dine on the yacht, you know. Cook could always rustle up a little, should we say a little cold pheasant? And his grape Suzette is something else.
Ten out of ten. Perseverance.
You know, the whole thing is mine. The whole damn kit and caboodle. I see you're not impressed. Well, maybe I should use my lonely old man approach. After the death of my wife, I thought I would never love again. But today, when I saw you standing by the side of the road, something within me stirred. Something that had laid dormant for a long time. Perhaps it was the way the wind sifted through your hair.
Mr. Robarts.
Miss Adams.
I give in.
Is that the young man you were telling me about? Well, it looks like I'll be having dinner alone then, huh?
Belle!
I'd better go.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Let me help you. Do you remember my name by any chance?
Malcolm Robarts.
Malcolm Robarts. Isn't that funny? That's exactly what it says in the local telephone directory. Is also informative as to my telephone number. I trust if you come this way again, you'll be giving me a call. Is that clear?
As day.
As day.
Au revoir.
Something before you left.
I didn't want to wake you.
But you just disappear like that.
I hadn't been gone 10 minutes and you drove past. I saw you.
How was I to know where you were?
Don't shout at me. Anyway, I was the one who was left stranded.
Not for long.
Look, since when do I have to ask you what I do? Just because you gave me a lift doesn't mean you own me.
Look, be honest, you just got fed up with me and decided to bugger off.
Oh, I did I? Without my coat.
Coat?
In the back of your car, or didn't you notice?
I said I'm sorry.
I don't want any apologies. I just want my coat. Now, where's your car?
I didn't see your bloody coat.
I'm sorry.
Your friend's back looking for you.
Hey, you!
It's not you he wants. It's me.
Thank you.
Wright was killed, it could have issued your description.
He's coming in. Lost him for good this time.
I'd still turn off if I were you.
Get me the police, please.
Have you had anything to eat?
No, I'm not hungry.
Bit late, but happy birthday.
What is it?
You open it later.
That was nice of you.
What are you going to do?
Don't know.
Will you give yourself up? I mean, you can't drive around forever.
Head back north, I suppose. Would you?
We're coming into Wickham.
Hmm?
Do you remember I told you I used to live here?
Oh, now, look, Belle, please.
I wouldn't stay long.
But Belle!
Oh, please. I mean, this is why I set out in the first place. Come on!
Hey, slow down!
Thank you.
Oh, thanks.
Cheers.
Cheers.
They're fast.
Listen, phone the police. Get them here, like yesterday. Police force in the country looking for me, and what am I doing? Riding around the countryside on a bloody horse.
All right, don't go on.
Look, I'm going to take you back to pick up your car.
Oh, it's much too far. Anyway, it won't be ready till tomorrow. Why don't we find a hotel somewhere?
Suppose we could. I could do with a bath, couldn't you?
Yes.
Well, don't look so shocked, Belle. I've seen it all before. And to think I used to hold you on my knee. Nature's a wonderful thing.
Miles. Southcliff. Feel a little happier with some mileage on the clock.
Your car.
Sorry.
You're missing a near side headlight.
Oh, yeah, I had a slight bump. I'll get it fixed tomorrow.
Let me see your license.
Sorry, I don't seem to have it with me.
Get that headlamp fixed in the morning. It's an offense to be without one. And dangerous.
Officer, is there a hotel around here?
Down the road, about 6 miles.
Want to stop off?
Why not?
Let's just hope they're not full.
Take anything they've got. Stephen. 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 Stephen.
Hmm?
Could I have a light?
Oh, sure. Surprised?
Full up.
Oh. Well, haven't you got anything? Oh, just one room will do.
With your wife?
Yeah, sure.
There's a fishing lodge in the grounds we sometimes use. It's not Buckingham Palace. It'll do for what you've got in mind. Sorry, dear. £10 for the night in advance.
Ten? Yeah, that'll be fine.
Keep on the way you're facing. It's about another 200 yards further on.
Are we finished with this?
Finished with it? Haven't had a chance to look at it yet. I'll take it. I know what's on telly.
Night.
Night, Mr. Jones.
That's okay.
Well, this is all they had. Do you want to go and open up and I'll go and park the car?
You can have a bath.
After you.
Sorry, the water's not hot. I have to wait till the morning.
Oh, well, I'm too tired anyway.
It's quite comfy.
Who's going to take the couch? You or me?
And me, of course. There must be a blanket somewhere.
Good night.
Good night.
Sleep well.
You too.
I've got a little present for you. Hmm? Don't look so scared. I'm not going to bite you.
Yeah. I'll put them on.
Yes?
Evening, Sarge.
Evening.
Jesus Christ.
Was
An ostrich egg. 4 hours.